This is a tale that you humans have passed down through uncounted generations. Tells of a war of unmatched scale and ferocity, the likes of which would never be seen again. One dark, fateful day, the earth cracked wide and malevolent forces rushed towards the invasion. Mounted a brutal assault upon the surface people, driving the land into deep despair. They burnt forest to ash, choked the land's sweet springs, and murdered without hesitation. To take the ultimate power protected by her grace, the goddess. The power she guided was without equal. Handed down by the gods of old, this power gave its holders the means to make any desire a reality.
Such was the might of the ultimate power. Old ones placed it in the care of the goddess. To prevent this great power from falling into the hands of the evil swarming the lands, the goddess gathered the surviving humans on an outcropping of Earth. She sent it skyward, beyond the reach of the demonic hordes, beyond even the clouds. With the humans safe, the goddess joined forces with the land dwellers and fought the evil forces, sealing them away. At last, peace was restored to the surface. This is a tale that you humans have told for many ages. Generation to generation. But there are other legends, long hidden away from memory, that are intertwined with this tale. Now, a new legend bound to this great story stands ready to be revealed. A legend that will be forged by your own hand.
Yeah.
Rise, Joseph. The time has come for you to awaken. You are fated to have a hand in a great destiny, and it will soon find you. The time has come for you to awaken. Joseph.
Sleepyhead, I know how much you like to sleep in, so I'm guessing this letter will be your alarm clock this morning. Did I guess right?
Rise and shine, Joseph.
Today's the wing ceremony. You promised to meet me before it starts, remember? You better not keep me waiting.
What's up, guys? Welcome to your Daily Dose of Joseph. I'm your host, Joseph Chase to Nintendo, and we are here with Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. Random, I know, right? I'm so excited. Oh my god, I've played this game since, like, something. When was this game released? November 2011, that's right. So, oh my god, I'm just so excited. I love this game. It was really tempting for the longest time. Okay, get up, Link. Don't be an idiot. It was tempting for the longest time to start this game up, but there were just so many things I wanted to get to first. So, anyways, let's just start off right here. You open up your little chest thing closet that has no clothing in it, and you get 5 rupees. And if I'm not mistaken, I believe that every time you reset the game, there will be 5 more rupees in there. So, it's the most tedious way to grind rupees if you're into that sort of thing. But we're not here to grind rupees, we're here to... Wait. Nobody's in danger. What's wrong with this? This is Zelda. Everybody's supposed to be in danger. Aren't I supposed to save people? Or is that too soon? What's this guy doing? He's golden. Why is he wearing my clothing? Why am I wearing this clothing? I should be wearing that, but green. Whatever. Hello, sir, who know my name? Yes, it's the wing ceremony. My body is ready. I don't know. What's a wing ceremony? Everyone else is out practicing at the plaza. I seem pretty relaxed. Yes, I am. I'm always relaxed. What are you talking about? And yes, I have a Crimson Loft wing. Come at me, bro. Apparently he thinks it's good to have a Crimson Loft wing. He says that he'd be confident if he had one as well. His bird won the last ceremony, but he doesn't think that he could beat my Red Terror, apparently. Alright, of course, a bird's true speed is a race always. In a race, always comes down to the skill of the rider, and I'm an amazing rider. With WRITER. Something. Bird researcher, his name's Pippet. I don't know, I'm too lazy to read the whole thing. And, you know, before we go any further, let me just get into some of the new mechanics that, if you ever play a Zelda game, third-person game, most of the time, unless it's handheld, normally those are overhead, and the older ones, of course, on Game Boy, SNES, NES. But, since it's been 3D, I think they pretty much invented the targeting system back on the Nintendo 64 with Ocarina of Time, and it's a very basic thing ever since. If the camera gets off-center, press Z. This is, of course, on the Nintendo Wii, and camera will lock behind him. To view first person, you hit C and you can look around, and this is something awesome that they added that was always in Zelda, is that you can look around, but now you can move. It's first person Zelda. Oh my god, who would have ever thunk it, except for the guy that made that Zelda 2 in first person game thing. What's going on with this guy? Hello, Joseph. The day of the wing ceremony is finally upon us. I don't think you speak like that. You look like an elf. Like, you legitimately look like a Lord of the Rings elf. Yes, I know how to something. I don't know what I'm doing. Now, okay, this guy's teaching you what I just told you pretty much, is to look in first person with C and move around. And also, if you see on the right there, it says center on the D-pad. This thing works with Wii Motion Plus to aim instead of the sensor bar. And if you feel like it's off kilter, you just hit the down button on the D-pad, and it'll center itself right up. Anyways, and one more thing that they added to the Zelda series with this one is the sprint button, which is you can't run inside. F to police. So, let's explore. That's my room. Not going back in there. I don't like my room. My room was pretty empty. What's this Groose guy? His room's locked. Lock? His room is locked. Alright. English is my first language. Colin and Stritch. Can I go in there? No, I have a feeling all these doors are gonna be locked since it's like the beginning of the game and everything. Fledge. Yeah, everything's locked. I'm just gonna stop looking. Unless I find something of interest. Anything? Seriously? Nothing else? I thought there were more. Whatever. So, let's come down here. What's going on with you? You, bro, look at me. Bro, look at me. Do you even lift?
I'm sorry, I just couldn't resist.
Yes, it is the morning. Actually, no, it's not. It's like 8 o'clock at night. He wants to fly, but he couldn't make the cut, so he's back in the academy. He needs to get these barrels into the kitchen. He wants to cheer me on, but he's busy here. So, I want all the friggin' fans I can get, so I'm gonna take this for him. Bro, see? Look at me. I lift. Oh, thanks. I didn't think you had time to help me out, Joseph. Not a problem. I need you to carry one of these barrels over to the old lady in the kitchen. Press A to pick up a barrel. I already did that. Then press A again to put it down at your feet. Alright, if you hold the Wii remote up and swing it, you can throw whatever you're carrying. You can roll small items like pots by holding the Wii remote down and swinging it, so it's like bowling. If you own a Wii, you've probably played Wii Sports and you know how to bowl. If I forget anything, I can press 2. That's another new feature. I didn't want to lock on him. They basically, if you press 2, you get tips about what you're currently doing. And right now, if you see that little green bubble, that also popped up when I was trying to run. But basically, that's also a new addition to the Zelda game, is a stamina meter. And basically, if that runs out, Link collapses into a heap. So set this down for a second, let him fill it up. It's probably fine. Like, I've heard some people complain about it, but it's not that bad. It doesn't last too long. Or, well, it lasts a while, but it doesn't take too long to recharge.
I thought I told Flange to carry that. But it's probably for the best. That skinny boy would probably have gotten flattened. Say, you don't have some important ceremony or some such today. Well, thanks for the help. Help.
You may have heard back there. My phone just went off. How professional of me. I forgot to turn my phone off. There, I took it into the kitchen. Thanks, that was a huge help, Joseph. I know it's not much, but here's half the pay the old lady offered me to do that. I feel like this is probably half of the pay. I don't know why I feel like I can't trust this guy. I feel like he's probably sticking me. But whatever. YOLO. Take all the money you can get. Ooh, bathroom. Oh yeah, I forgot about this. You guys ready? Bam. New mechanic. That's right. Don't worry about that. Now, you know, there's doors, big doors down there. But I don't want to see what's behind big door, because, you know, big door's always, oh my god, what? Who wants my attention?
Hey!
Pippet! What? What do you want?
If you're heading over to the plaza, the quickest way is out the door on the ground floor. The exit door up at the top is locked, so you blow. Where's the lunch lady? Wait.
What's taking lunch lady so long? I'm going to have a word with her.
Yeah, shut up. Shut up! Fine, I'll go at the front bottom door.
Oh, Malibu, get... Don't touch me, I'm recording. You see what you done? You see what you done? You got yourself caught in my jeans. That's my cat, folks. Cat usually ignores it. Oh no, cat, don't play with the wires. Welcome, everybody, to the land of Skyloft. That couldn't have been perfect timing. I just took a shot. I'm happy that thing popped up when I said so. So, this is Link's home in this game. If you realize, he lives in an academy, so he's at like boarding school. And I don't know why, Link was a bad boy. He did something bad. What do you want?
Hello, Joseph, up here.
I don't know if that's probably doesn't fit his voice. Good morning, Joseph. Today's finally the day of the long-awaited wing ceremony. Everybody keeps talking about what the heck is a wing ceremony. Give me a frickin' bone here. Nobody take that the wrong way. Yes, I'm ready. Holding Z and press A to have a quick chat with him. Yes, you can target people at distance and talk to them like that. You can press Z to target something. Once you target on someone, you can easily talk to him or her, pressing A, whiz, blah, blah, blah. Instantly to carry on a conversation from a distance, why don't you come join me up here? Yes, I'll join you up here. I was trying to do that, but you interrupted me. Climb up and dash towards the wooden boxes. Bleh. Alright. Fine, I will climb your boxes. I will be a part of this stupid system. Whoa. Link's got some mad skills. Anybody want to agree with that? What do you think about using A to dash? It's useful, isn't it? However, don't dash around so much. You'll tire yourself out. And stamina gauge, basically what I just explained. Take a break when your stamina gauge gets close to empty. Got that. On to the next point. You can jump short distances just by moving forward. You'll auto-jump. Ah, yes, auto-jump. Yes, just like that. And now he's got a speech bubble over his head, or a thought bubble, or whatever the heck dots bubble that is, because he wants to have a conversation with you. So what are you up to? Rushing to get some last-minute bird-riding practice this morning, Joseph? Oh, you have someone to meet? Oh, Zelda's waiting for you, isn't she? Zelda's
waiting for me. It's perfect timing.
Her father, Headmaster Gabora, his pet named Mia, and blah, scampered off. His cat got away, basically.
Look at that little animal. Looks so cute from a distance.
Alright, so the headmaster's preparing, so he wanted to, he's supposed to... This guy, whatever his name is, can't remember it, he was supposed to get the headmaster's whatever thing down from the building, and now he's passing his work on to me. So, let's just go ahead. Now, we're holding on to the wood. I'm trying to think of a way to relate this to Minish Cap. Mirror's Edge. That's the M word, right? It was an M word. Wrong game. No! No!
I did that so many times before.
No, Link, don't get tired on me. Oh, boy. Alright, let's get back over there. And... saw nothing. Alright. So, now we're back over here. Now, let's not fail it this time. Oh, and also while you're riding the wall, climbing the wall, or whatever, if you swing the remote, Malibu, stop being adorable. Ah, I almost fell. Malibu, get out. You're distracting me. I know you're an attention whore, but come on. Give me some room here. Look, man, I want to give my own tutorial. You don't need to give them a tutorial. I know this game. Meh! Alright, so basically he's just explaining to you Zelda mechanics. You walk up to a block, you press A, you move the stick in forward, towards the box where you're holding it, and Link will grab it and push it.
Look at it! Oh my god! It's so cute! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god, it's so adorable! Look at you! Oh my god! I can throw you? I could never do that. You're too cute. I'll never throw you off of anything. Ever. No matter how... life-saving?
I don't know. Why would I have to throw?
Why am I still using that voice? I have no reason to throw something this adorable. I'm surprised the game even gives you that option. I'm surprised Peter didn't get mad at that, yet they get mad at Mario's Tanuki suit. What kind of crap is that? Alright, yes, I brought her set back safe and sound. It's okay, it was no trouble. I like Mia, she's adorable. Tell the headmaster we found his pet. He should be up at Statue of the Goddess. I guess the goddess looked like an angel with that guy's hair. I believe Zelda is with him, so you should hurry along. Oh, heck yeah. I got a date. So this, oh man, this guy's got something to talk about too. What do you want, homie? How's life? Life's going rockin', brah. Anyways, yes, I slept. Figured you'd be hot, tossing and turning all night, thinking about the big ceremony today. What is the ceremony that everybody keeps talking about? Just fixing this gate here. You know, it's been squeaking. We can't have that done the day of the ceremony. Tell that to my chair. Send your prayers to the goddess this morning. Just face the bird statue over there and say a short prayer to save your progress. Breaking the fourth wall already, right out of the gate. First freaking half hour of the game. Not even. First 20 minutes of the game. We're already. We already breaking the fourth wall. Alright. Cat! Cat's attacking my bag. The bag where I keep my recording supplies. Now this over here. I would explain it myself, but the game's gonna explain it anyways. You got stamina fruit. This particular fruit replenishes your stamina gauge. When I first got that, I thought that it went into my inventory and I was supposed to grab it. And then, I could check my inventory later and eat it and fill up my stamina. But then I'm like, oh, my stamina fills up so fast, why would I need that? It doesn't work like that, right? You see? Just run in circles. He's all tired. Bam! Touch it. Full stamina. Booyah! Alright. So, let's go ahead and send a prayer real quick. Let's, save the game. And it has been saved. The first save I've ever made in this game. That's a lie. I beat this game when it came out, November 2011. Good times. Good times. Oh my god. It's pink. Is that Zelda? Is that Zelda? I don't know. I think it's Zelda. But we will not find out this time. But maybe we'll find out next time.